total isolation, no contact to the outer world. Nearly daily interrogations. The isolation, the loneliness, it was torture for me. My name is Jochen Scheidler. I was 24 years old when I made the experience of imprisonment in jail. And it was because I distributed leaflets against the invasion of the troops of the Warsaw Pact in Czechoslovakia. This interrogational prison was situated inside of a large restricted area. Nobody should know what was inside. Nobody should know it was a secret headquarter of the Stasi. When I arrived in this prison in a closed car, in a tiny box, I was inside of a garage, brightly illuminated. It was a shock for my eyes. I could hardly see anything. Only men in uniform around me, shouting on me, "Head down, go upstairs." Three guards around me, they opened the handcuffs and I had to strip completely, to give off everything. And then one of the guard pulled over a rubber glove and inspected every hole in the body. After this, I had to cross the floor naked to get the prisoner's clothing. And it was the beginning of a long period of isolation, cutting out all connections to the outer world. This is the room of the interrogator. I was delivered here by a guard, which introduced me to sit in the corner behind the door on a tiny seat all the time, no touching the wall, to kept in isolation torture, was to get information of our friends and families and working mates. And there were crazy rules to obey inside of the cell. You have to sleep in a special position. Then you have been waked up by the guard who opened the flap in the door and shouted in, "Keep sleeping order." So I was waked up. Next morning, I was nervously in the interrogations then. One of the interrogators told me that my father is deadly ill and I should soon tell everything they would like to know from me. To see my father still alive, depends on me how long you have to be here. This was a dirty trick of operational psychology. That was a subject the interrogators have been studied on the special university only for Stasi people. I think they were deeply sure that they are doing a very important job to fight enemies of socialism, to protect the socialistic society, to be the good part. The prisoners have been transported across the DDR by this kind of a specialized railway wagon. It seemed to be a post wagon. Nobody should know what was transported inside. There was no climatization. The wagon could be on its way between two prisons for up to 2 days. I think it's very important to remember those times because it could come back if we don't see the signs of left and right wing extremists rising power. I think just now it's a dangerous time and all Democrats have been very sensible to see the signs and to fight terrorists and the extremists.